In this video, I will show you a few compositing tricks that I use to improve this render. I will also show you where you can get good free overlays, so I recommend you watch this video until the end. I talk about how I created this scene in the last video. You can watch it after this video if you want. This video is sponsored by Squarespace, more about that later. First, I activated mist and glossy direction paths because I will need them later. I use PNG 16-bit per channel to get as much information as possible. In the world settings, we have settings for mist paths. We can turn on the preview in material mode. Given that the camera is 60 meters away from the house, the default values are not good for us. I roughly need this part, which is about 30 meters from the camera and up to 80 meters. Now I can press F12 to render and go to Compositor. If we open Blender Compositor, we have render and passes that we have activated. First, click on Use Nodes and Backdrop. With activated Node Wrangler add-on, Ctrl plus Shift on render layers to activate Viewer layer. With Ctrl plus Shift plus click on the render layer, you can also preview passes. You can zoom out or zoom in with V or Alt V. How to create a fog effect? Fog creates lower visibility in the distance, so object further from the camera should be more blurred. If we mix a render with a blurry render, we can choose the percentage of the blur, but equally on the whole image. We want to blur only the background. For that, we need mist pass in combination with color ramp. Now we can control where we want it to be blurred in 3D space. Where there is a higher percentage of white, the second input will be more visible. I want to keep the character completely in the focus, but let some fog on the house and even more on the tree in the background. If we want to go a step further, we can use the fog texture instead of blur node. I downloaded this free pack of fog overlays in the description of this video. But at the end of this video, I will show you where you can find and download more overlays that I use a lot. It is necessary to first adjust the scale and position and set the multiply blending mode to remove the black color. You can add as many layers as you want. With the help of glossy direction pass, we can highlight glossiness. I want to add that effect only to part of the roof. I need a mask for that. You can find a shortcut for creating a mask in the image editor. And you can create a mask with Ctrl plus left click. Now we can add a mask node and use it as a vector. Glossy part is only on the roof, but also on the sky in the background, which we don't want. To fix this, I multiplied the mask with the mist pass to control where the effects will be visible in 3D space. The effect will appear where there is white color, so we need to turn the color ramp in this case. Now we just need to add a feather to the mask to avoid sharp transition and control the intensity with the color ramp. Before we continue with the video, let me introduce Squarespace. Squarespace is a website building platform designed to enable users to create stunning and functional websites easily. Squarespace also provides various tools to help users create, manage and accept payments for online stores. This includes zero transaction fees on commerce plans, inventory and order management, tax tools, and integrated shipping options. There are also built-in search engine optimization capabilities, helping websites rank higher in the search result and attract more visitors. Additionally, the platform provides advanced analytics for users to track their website performance, enabling them to make data-driven decisions to improve their site's reach and effectiveness. These features, along with many others, make it a powerful choice for businesses that sell products online. Go to squarespace.com for a free trial, and when you are ready to launch, go to squarespace.com/simebulgaria to save 10% of your first purchase of a website or domain. To highlight the orange color and create a glow effect, I added a new mix node. The upper input is render and the lower orange solid. I set screen blending mode. After that, I created a mask in the place where I want the orange glow effect. I created the effect in the sky in the same way, only this time I use a light blue color and adjust the mask so that the effect is only visible in the sky. Now we have a nice vignetting effect that puts the focus on the house. Grain or noise is one of the effects that will make each render more realistic because each camera creates it, but not 3D render, which means that we need to create it in the compositor. You can create a noise texture and use it as an overlay, but the noise texture doesn't look like the grain created by the camera should look like. That's why the best option is to look for some grain overlay from the internet. I found this interesting package of retro grain, scratches and leaking overlays. My advice is to create a folder on your computer where you collect overlays that you can use whenever you need. I will share with you the overlays/links.txt file in the description, where you can find links to some of the free overlays that I have downloaded in the past. To use the overlay, you just need to mix the render and the overlay texture, adjust the scale of the overlay to the render, and use one of the blending modes. In order to remove blacks and keep whites, it is necessary to use blending modes from this container, most often screen. To remove the whites and keep blacks, some inside of this container usually multiply. To remove gray tones, we usually need overlay blending mode. If you want to know exactly what each blending mode does, you can find out this video. The video is about Photoshop, but it is the same for almost every software. I use this Kodak overlay to emphasize the cinematic look, but you can use any overlay of your choice. That's all for this video. If you want to know how I created the whole scene and more about compositing, look for the step-by-step tutorial on Patreon or by clicking on YouTube join link. You can also download the Blender file or watch my other tutorials there. Thanks for watching. Please click like or subscribe if you like this video. It helps the channel a lot.